Welcome students,
in today's lecture we'll be discussing about FIBSC computer science syllabus, what it contains, how many subjects are there, and what are the outcomes of your subject and what to study. So basically we'll be having 7 subjects altogether in semester 1, starting with computer organization and design. Second is programming with Python 1, free and open source software. Then we have database system. Then we have discrete mathematics. Then we have a subject called descriptive statistics and introduction to probability, which is commonly known as DSIP. And last subject, that will be your soft skill development. So basically this is your communication skill. So total 7 subjects will be there. Each subject carries three units and 2 credits will be given to each subject. So you'll be having 3 lectures per week in a college. So let's get started with your actual syllabus. Now, what is your computer organization and design? So as its name suggests, computer organization and design, it is mainly about the structure and operation of modern processors and their instruction sets. So it will be mainly dealing about your, how your computers are organized, how, what are the designing system of your computers, how it can be managed. So what you'll be learning, to learn about what computer system work and underlying principles, to understand the basic of digital electronics needed for computers. So basically this is somewhat relevant to your digital electronics syllabus. So to understand the basic of instruction set architecture for reduced and complex complex instruction set, that will be a CISC and RISC set, to understand the basic of processor structure and operation, to understand how data is transferred between processor and IO devices. So mainly we are discussing about your processors and your IO devices. IO stands for your input and output. So let's see the syllabus actually of COD. It is often called as COD, computer organization and design. So remember, you'll be remembering this subject by its abbreviation or short forms. So unit 1 will tell you more about computer abstraction and technology, how it evolves, the basic structure and operation of computer. Then we had a functional unit and their interaction, then representation of numbers and characters. So basically number computer system takes 2 input, either it is taking numbers in terms of your binaries, binary digit takes 0 and 1 as an input, and characters. So string will be made by your characters. So then we have logical circuit and functional. So I hope you have studied this logical circuit in 11th or 12th standard. That will be a Boolean algebra, logic gates, AND gate, NOT gate, AND gate, NAND gate, and so on. Then we have, will be having flip-flops, gates, half adder, full adder, tri-state buffer devices, and so on. So you'll be learning about K-map, Karnaugh maps, in this particular chapter. In unit 2, we'll be learning about instruction set architecture. Basically, it is all about memory organization, addressing and operations. Then we have word size, then big Indian, little Indian arrangements, instruction sequencing. Then we have instruction set for RISC and CISC. As I said, reduced instruction set and complex instruction sets. Then we have operand addressing mode and processor. Then RISC and CISC examples are there. So in unit 2, we'll be learning about more about RISC and CISC example. Then moving ahead, we have in unit 3, we'll be learning about basic processor unit, that is your main component of a processor, how it is, how it constructed, how it works. Then what are the register it requires. Then we have register files, ALU control unit, instruction fetch unit, interfaces to instruction, and data memories, data path. Hello, am I audible properly? Okay. Hello. So might be your network connection is unstable. Sorry for that. So basic processor unit, main component of a processor, register and register files, ALU. ALU stands for your arithmetical logical unit, control unit, instruction fetch unit, interfaces to instruction and data memories. Then we have data path, instruction fetch and execute. Then we'll be discussing about arithmetic and logical execution of your memory access. And at last chapter, we'll be studying about basic input and output devices, what kind of input output devices we are using, data transfer between our processors and IO devices, interrupts and exceptions are there, interrupt requests and processings are there basically. So we'll be learning about this basic IO. So books precise by university. First refer your textbook, Carl Hamesher, Computer Organization and Embedded System 6th edition. Will be McGraw-Hill 2012. So it is available on Google. You can just browse and search. So you'll get this book. Two additional references are given by University of Mumbai. Patterns and Hennison, Computer Organization and Design, Morgan Kaufman. Then we have RP Jain. See, this RP Jain's book of Modern Digital Electronics is a pioneer book in your digital electronic concepts. So the same book is applicable with your digital electronics of first year BSc IT. So it is also by Tata McGraw-Hill Educations Private Limited. So is it okay? So just raise your hand if you are clear with COD syllabus. Hello. So this is an introduction lecture just. So we are formally discussing about your syllabus of all subjects. When we actually start with your lectures, we'll be discussing more in more detail about all the subjects by the concerned faculties. Now moving ahead, done with this. So programming with Python. So Python is a programming language, high level programming language. So which is more compatible with your machine learning, AI and robotics nowadays. It is a popular programming language. And it is very simple programming language if you follow the basics properly. So objective of this paper to introduce a various concept of programming to the student using Python. So what you will learn from this subject? Student should be able to understand the concept of programming before actually starting with the right program. See, basically, when we discuss about writing your programs in programming, three things are very important. First is what to use. First thing is what to use. Second thing is how to use. And third thing is where to use. First thing is what to use. Second thing is how to use. And third thing is where to use. So students should be able to develop a logic from problem solving. So it's not like you will be copy pasting this code and just running and executing your programs. So you need to develop a logic of your own so you can get a better skills and knowledge related to this subject. So students should be made familiar about the constructing basic concept of programs such as data, operation, condition, loops and functions. So you can apply your problem solving skill by using this Python. So currently we are using highest version of Python is 3.8.5. I am using 3.8.5 for my SYIT practicals. So it's recommended to use a better version or upgraded version of Python. So let's see what is there in syllabus. So unit 1. So it looks messy a little bit, but if you just extract what are the concepts are there, reason for Python as a learner's first programming language, then introduction to IDLE. So basically Python provides two modes. One is shell script mode and other mode is interactive mode. So unlike your other programming languages, Python don't provide any compiler. It has interpreter. So what are the differences? Then expression and operators, then built-in function types are there. What kind of compound statements are there? Assertive statements are there. Expression statements are there. Operands are there. Boolean values, assignment statement. Then we have implicit and declaration of variables. Then statement list, del statements are there. Import statements, built-in help. How to start shell, restart shell. Then several compound statements we'll be discussing about that. What kind of data structures or data types are available? Like your tuple, list. What are parentheses, difference between brackets, parentheses and braces. Then indexing individual elements within this type. So strings and tuples are immutable. So Python basically provides two objects. One is immutable and other is mutable. So when you are able to change within that object, that is your mutable objects. And when you are not able to change within that object, that is your immutable object. So lists are immutable. Tuples are immutable. So built-in functions like your mean, max, sum, and interactive solution and model problems are this. So we'll be discussing more about this subject as I'm taking your Python. Then we'll be studying about advantages of functions, function parameters, formal parameters, actual parameters, global and local variable declarations are there. Then we have range function, the iterative for statements, the conditional statements like if else, if else. Then we have interactive statements while else, for else. So basically, Python provides two kinds of functions. One is known as built-in function. one is known as built-in function, one is known as built-in function, and other is known as user-defined function. So when we are defining user-defined function, we'll be using that def keyword. We'll be using that def keyword. So remember that. So we'll be discussing more about this concept once we start with your actual syllabus. Then we'll be learning about dictionaries. What is a dictionary? So dictionary is basically a key and value pairs. So what are the techniques to create, update, delete, and dictionary items? How it can be traversed and how it can be searched. Then in unit 3, we'll be learning about anonymous functions. It includes list comprehension, then general introduction to object-oriented programming. So using a built-in dir function, enumerate the method of strings, tuples, list, dictionaries, using this method for problem solving with compound types. So university has researched 2 books, Magnus Lyle Hetland, Beginning Python from Novice to Professional by your Aprex publisher. Then Paul Grace, Practical Programming and Introduction to Computer Science using Python, Pragmatic Bookshelf, edition 2014. So Python is more of a practical oriented subject. So don't take it as a theory subject or theoretical subject. So you'll enjoy once you start performing practicals in Python. So remember, in Python, most common errors are your indentation. So unnecessary or unwanted spaces has to be avoided. Now moving ahead. Next concept is very simple subject, free and open source software. So see, what is a free and open source software? The softwares which source is open for all the programmers, means you can actually edit its compilers. You can actually edit its compilers and you can change within that compilers and you can upload your own compiler. So open source had acquired a prominent place in software industries and having knowledge and related technology essential computer science students. So what you'll be learning in this subject particularly, upon completion of this course, students should have a good working knowledge of open source ecosystem. See, this system is a very different system apart from your traditional computer systems. So it uses impact and importance kind of things. So this course shall help the student to learn open source methodologies, case studies, and real life example. So see, this subject is more of your case study kind of thing. So it is very easy subject. Don't panic about this subject. So unit 1 tell you about what is an open source, free softwares, free software versus open source softwares, public domain, false does not mean no cost, history like BSD parameters, bash shell parameter, GNU project. GNU stands for GNU is not Unix. Then we have philosophy of this Apache BSD false licensing. Then we have several kind of things like patents, economic of FOSS. So it includes zero marginal cost, income generation, opportunities, problems with traditional commercial software. Then we will be learning about internationalization, social impact, open source versus closed source, shared software, what do you mean by shared ethics and all that. Then we'll be learning about case studies, example with projects. So we'll be mostly focusing on Apache web server, GNU Linux, Android, Mozilla, Wikipedia, Drupal, WordPress, GCC, GDB, GitHub, OpenOffice. So these are the example of your open source. So remember this, I'm again repeating Apache web server, GNU Linux, Android, Mozilla, Wikipedia, Drupal, WordPress, GCC, and GDB. See, GCC is your compiler. Drupal is a framework. WordPress is a framework for designing websites. Remember that. GitHub is an open source platform to code, upload your compilers and code. OpenOffice is a product of Linux also. So it is also open source, like your Microsoft Office. Unlike your Microsoft Office, see, Microsoft Office is a vendor-specific software. Study understanding that development models, licensing, then we'll be learning about Wikipedia and how one can contribute to its open source projects and other things, that communication and interaction within that community. Then in Unit 3, we'll be learning about open source ecosystem, hardware, virtualization technologies, LAMP technologies there, IDEs, debuggers, and open source database technologies. So basically this subject is more kind of your case studies subject. So it's a very easy subject. As you can see, only 2 books have been precise by University of Mumbai. That 2 of Unix, you can see, because Unix and open source software. So additional references are given. If you want to visit, you can visit. I'll be providing this PPT after this lecture. Don't worry. The Linux documentation project is there. Docker is there. Open source. See, more often you'll see Linux kind of things in this. GitHub is there, Linux foundations are there. So done with this, moving ahead, we have very important concept apart from your programming languages or apart from your hardware part or software part. Apart from your softwares, apart from your hardwares or networks or other things, you have very important things, database system. So it contains your actual data or backend kind of thing. See, in database system, either you will be using MySQL, SQL, or PLSQL, that is your Oracle kind of things. So what you'll be learning? So students should able to evaluate business information problem and find the requirements of a problem in the terms of data. So databases are there, what kind of data you can store, what kind of model or approaches you can use within this database system. Specifically, you can use this DML, DCL, DDL statements. So students should be able to create, manipulate, query, and backup the database. So everything will related to your DBMS you will be learning in this subject. So unit one more tell, see, whatever subject or whichever subject you are learning, so focus on first chapter itself, because first chapter is an introduction part of that chapter, which has a summary of overall syllabus or glimpse of that syllabus. So you'll be learning DBMS, what kind of architecture, data independence, level of abstraction. It includes physical and logical level of abstraction, data independence, logical data, physical data. Data models are there, DCL. Then we have ERD models, what kind of entities you can use. Then we'll be learning about what is in keys, primary keys and other things. Then we'll be learning about relational data models, how one can convert ER table to data, or table to ER diagram to table, or table to ER diagram. Then we'll be learning about schema refinement and normal forms. So basically we'll be learning about first, second, third and fourth normal form. Total five normal forms are there, and one more normal form is there, BCNF, Boy Scout normal form it is known as. Then we'll be learning about joins, then algebra operation, or you can just say relational and algebraic operations using selection operation, projection and set operation using union, intersection, difference and cross products. So you'll be learning about joins. So basically joins are of two types, inner join and outer join. So that can be other divided, subdivided into two types, right join and left join. Equijoin is also there, DDL statements are there. So it can be used for creating databases, using databases, data types and creating tables. So with an integrity constraint. So primary keys are there, dropping tables. Now how, what is the difference between deleting a table or truncating table, backing up and restoring databases. Aggregate functions are there, like your count, mean, max, average and sum. So second unit will tells you in more detail about schema refinement, normal forms and other operations that can be performed your database. So in unit 3, we'll be learning about functions, what kind of functions you can use with your databases, string functions like concat, insert, left, right, mid, length, lowercase, uppercase, replace, extra, string comparison, trim, rtrim, reftrim. Then several math functions are there, power, det functions. So more often we'll be discussing about these functions, then how to join table, subqueries, then views are there. What is the role of DBA? DBA stands for database administrator. It is also known as a super user, or DBA stands for database administrator. So it has all the privileges that is associated with your databases. So done with this DBMS. So textbooks is simple. Ramesh Elsmeri, Shamakant Nawate, Fundamental Database System, PSN Education, 6th edition, 2010. So this is a basic book. I have preferred this book. Three books I have preferred as a student. So Ramakrishnan Gherke, Database Management System by McGraw-Hill. Joel Murach, Murach MySQL, Murach. So see, as you can notice, their editions are very old, but concepts are modern day concepts. So don't worry. So nothing changed. Additional references, Robert Sheldon, Job Merge, Beginning MySQL, Rockspress, 2005. Now, after this, databases, programming, and other things, we'll be discussing about your mathematics parts. So discrete mathematics, it is different. See, it is not a mathematics, it is a discrete mathematics. So basically, we have two types, continuous elements and discrete element. Discrete means without continuation, and continuation is continuation. So discrete mathematics, you will be learning about objects, relational sets, graphs and trees. That's it. So in first unit we'll be learning about functions, bijective, surjective, injective functions are there, then mapping, domain and codomaining of your functions. Then we'll be learning about relations, what kind of relations you can have, recurrence relation, how to use this in a constant coefficient and this relations. So in unit 1 we'll be learning about functions, relation and recurrence relations. Is that clear? Now moving ahead, in unit 2 we'll be learning about counting principles, languages and finite state machines. So FSM is a just an introduction part within this discrete mathematics. In second year, third sem, theory of computation, you have a detailed idea about finite state machine and what are the types of FSM you can use. So in this counting principle, you can use this sum and product rules, two-way countings are there, binomial theorem, Pascal triangles are there, Van der Mol identity is there. So languages and grammars and machines you can have, Gödel number and regular expression and Turing machine. So basic, see, remember in unit 2, third part you have to be very precise because several basic introduction is there of your SYCS theory of computations. You will be learning this concept in advance. So focus on this concept while studying. Then in unit 3, you'll be learning graphs and trees. So graphs, what are graphs? Adjacency matrix, path matrix representing your relations using diagraph. Warshall's algorithm is there. How to find shortest path, link representation of a graph, operation on graph with algorithm, searching in graph. Then two approaches, that is BFS and DFS, breadth first search and depth first search. Then we'll be learning about trees. What are the trees? Then we'll be learning binary trees, their siblings, nodes and other things. So moving ahead, textbook. The first textbook itself is a very good textbook. You can refer and you will find all the concept and all the topics that are covered in this textbook, Discrete Mathematics and its application, 7th edition by Kenneth Rosen, Macravelli edition. So done with this Discrete Mathematics. Again, you have one more subject that is relevant to mathematics, but more often it is kind of probability. So descriptive statistics and introduction to probability, it is often known as DSIP. It is often known as DSIP, descriptive statistics and introduction to probability. So what you'll be learning in this subject? So statistical concept and probability concept relevant to your computer concepts. So you'll be using R programming for this subject practicals. So actual manual of this DSIP is uploaded on my site. You can visit anytime. So in unit 1, you'll be learning about data presentation, what kind of data types are there, what kind of attributes to data presentation, frequency distribution, histogram, curves, stems and lift display. In second chapter, you'll be learning data aggregation, tendency, mean, median, mod, discrete group frequency distribution, quantities in or quartiles in frequency distributions are there. In real life examples are there. In unit 2, you'll be learning about moments, majorness of skewness and kurtosis, and regression, correlation and regression. linear regressions are there. So in unit 3, you'll be learning about actual probability. That includes your random experiment, sample space, event types, operation and events probability definitions. So and last, conditional probability, Bayes theorem, independence, example on probability. So in unit 3, you'll be learning about probability. So in this overall subject, you'll be learning about descriptive statistics and introduction to probability. So it is a mixture of your statistics as well as your probability. See, remember, you have to perform these practicals on R programming. For Python, you have to use Python 3.8.5. DBMS, either you can go for MySQL or you can go for SQL Server or you can use Oracle. So depending upon which software is insisted by your college concerned faculty. Is that clear? Now moving ahead, textbooks, Trivedi, probability and statistics. So one book is enough for reference. That is by Prentice Hall of India, New Delhi. So other additional references are there. Few topics are given very nicely in this. You can just refer. Now moving ahead, that will be your last subject of this semester one. Soft skill development, most ignored subject of semester one. Student take this subject very lightly and they don't know the importance of this subject. See, soft skill development is very important as per your jobs are concerned after your academics. See, whatever skills you are acquiring in technical terms or other terms, it's good, but students are lagging behind in their communication skill or spoken skills. So this subject is telling you more about your communication skill and soft skill development. So in unit 1, we'll be discussing about introduction to soft skill and hard skill personality development. See, unless and until you're willing to change your personality, no one is going to change your personality. So that is one more thing I have to tell. So knowing yourself, positive thinking, George window, communication skill, non-verbal communication, physical fitness, emotional intelligence, then etiquette and mannerism, how to behave and all these things. Communication 2 days, they are. Then 3GM models of communication, academic skill employment communication, what kind of communication is required for professional presentation, how job interviews are scheduled, and how it is organized. Introduction, importance of resume, definition of your interview, group discussion. It is a very important concept in corporate, group discussions. While at the time of your interview, they just give a topic for a group discussion and check your confidence and your knowledge on that topic. Then unit 3, professional skills and creativity at workplace, ethical values are there. Learn capacity building, learn, unlearn and relearn. Leadership and team buildings are there. Then we have decision making and negotiation. Then we have stress and time management, which is a very important topic or aspect considering this current situation or COVID-19 pandemic, stress and time management. So stress management and time management has to be very accurate and proper. So it can be beneficial for you while dealing with this kind of pandemic situations. So textbook is Soft Skills and Integrated Approach to Maximize Personality, Gajendra S. Chauhan, Sangeeta S. Sharma, Willy India. Now, what are the jobs after CS? Either you can go for software development in programming, in that website development, mobile, embedded system programming, embedded system development, software testing, networking, database administration, system administration, cyber law consultant, GIS, IT service, security, ethical hacker, cyber forensic expert, game developer, game tester, and so many jobs are there. But main point or main topic of discussion is you require that adequate skills to grasp that job. So for more lectures or study material, you can visit my site. For more lectures, you can visit my YouTube channel. So this is done. I'm done with my syllabus introduction. So basically, you'll be learning 7 subjects, namely computer organization and design, programming with Python 1, free and open source software, database system, discrete mathematics, descriptive statistics, introduction to probability, soft skill development. So you'll be having practicals for 6 subjects at least. You don't have a practical for soft skill development. Instead, you have case study.